टुडे वी आर मेकिंग दिस ढाबा स्टाइल बटर दाल एंड तंदूरी रोटी कॉम्बो. दिस इज़ नॉट द नॉर्मल उल्टा तवा मेथड ऑफ मेकिंग तंदूरी रोटी गाइज. आई एम शेयरिंग अ डिफरेंट मेथड एंड द दाल विल कम आउट सुपर टेस्टी. सो हे फूडीज, वेलकम टू कुकिंग शुकिंग. लेट्स मेक बटर दाल एंड तंदूरी रोटी विच विल बी सुपर क्रिस्पी. फॉर मेकिंग द बटर दाल, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू सोक द दाल. यर आई हैव अ बोल. आई एम टेकिंग 3 tablespoons ऑफ चना दाल and 3 tablespoons of moong dal. This much quantity will be good for 3 to 4 people. We will add water and wash it a couple of times. You can mix and match your favorite dals and don't throw this dal water guys. It is good for plants, you can give it to that. Now let's add some fresh water to the dal and soak it for minimum 30 minutes. After the dal is soaked, we will take a pressure cooker, add the dal in along with the water we soaked it in and a cup more of fresh water, about half a teaspoon of haldi powder, some salt and a little bit of ghee. Let's cover it. We will place it on high heat for 4 whistles and 5 minutes on low heat after that. While the dal is cooking, let's make the dough for this amazing tandoori roti. So in a parat, I am taking 2 cups of gehu ka aata or whole wheat flour, some salt and we will use water to make a dough. Guys, you must have seen at some places the tandoori roti is very white in color. That is because the dhabas or the restaurants many time use R atta or chalani atta or resultant atta to make the roti. It is also used for making pani puri. We will talk more about it in some other video. In nutrition, it is very similar to the chakki atta that we generally eat. For now, you can see the dough is getting soft and smooth. I've kneaded it well. It's good for now. Let's cover it and we will let it rest for about 15 minutes. The time is up for the dal. Let's turn it off and while the cooker is cooling down naturally, let's prepare the vegetables for the tadka. Here I have tomato and an onion. We will cut them. We just need half each. No need to cut very fine. We will cut them roughly. Guys, also the butter dal has a unique flavor because it is cooked on coal. So at home we can't cook it on coal, but we can get that similar flavor with some coal. Here I am turning on the heat, placing a charcoal so that we can smoke the dal for getting a very similar flavor. The onion and tomato are done. I am chopping some coriander leaves as well. And now the preparation is done. The cooker has cooled down. I've opened it. The dal is cooked. Let's churn it to mash the dal. Don't mash it very much, we want some of the chana dal intact. Here you can see the dal looks good. Now let's give it the tadka. Here I have a kadai heating on high heat. We will add butter, 50 grams. You heard that right, 50 grams of butter. Before it melts, we will add the red chili powder, 2 teaspoons. This is regular red chili powder guys, not Kashmiri, because the recipe is famous in Nagpur. People love spicy food there. We won't cook this very much, cook it for about 10 to 15 seconds and now you can see this is looking good. We will add the onion to arrest the cooking. No more danger of the butter burning now. We will give it a stir, cook until the onions are transparent. Also, we will save some of the chili butter, which is basically the rogan, for garnishing it. Here you can see the onion is done. Now let's add the tomato. Don't worry about cooking the tomato right now guys, we will add the dal as well. We will boil the tomato along with the dal. As you can see, this butter dal is on the thinner side and that's what we want, unlike dal makhni which is very thick. We will keep it thin. If the dal that you are cooking is not very thin, then you can add water because we are going to boil it really well. Add some salt so that we can season the onion and tomato that we added. Now we have to boil this on high flame for 4 to 5 minutes. Stir this every now and then and you should be good. The butter which was floating earlier is now mixing well. The dal is almost done. We will add some coriander leaves, let it heat once, I mean give it a boil and turn off the flame. Now remember the charcoal we heated earlier, place it in a metal bowl and place it over the dal. It will float guys, don't worry about it, and then drop a little bit of ghee on top, quickly cover it with the lid and let it smoke. बट डोंट कीप इट फॉर क्लोज्ड फॉर एनी लॉन्गर देन 5 सेकेंड्स. यू हर्ड मी राइट, जस्ट 5 सेकेंड्स. ट्रस्ट मी व्हेन आई से द फ्लेवर विल बी टोटली गॉन फॉर अ टॉस, द स्मोक विल ओवरपावर एवरीथिंग. एंड एज आई वॉज सेइंग दिस, यू कैन सी द लिड इज आउट बिकॉज वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू स्मोक इट फॉर वेरी लॉन्ग. About 5 to 6 seconds and the dal is smoked and ready. Now let's quickly make the tandoori roti. The dough has rested, let's divide it into small portions. Size of a puri guys, here you can see. Now we will smoothen it. Dust them with some dry atta and roll them oblong. Something like this. This is similar to the size of a puri. Better one would be similar to the size of your palm. This looks good. Now let's heat up a tawa. The tawa is hot. We will place the roti, cook it on medium heat until the bottom side cooks a little. Flip it and cook it until light golden. We are not cooking the roti completely right now, we are just half cooking it. This one is done and you can prepare half cooked rotis like this until serving time. You can keep it for up to 2 hours. That's how much I have tested it guys. You can keep it for longer as well. Serving time, we will make it tandoori. For that, here I have a pop-up toaster. So this is basically a bread toaster that we generally all have. We will turn it on, let it preheat a little for about 30 seconds. After that, we will grab the roti that we made earlier, stop the toaster, place the roti, pull the trigger down and cook it until it is golden. The rotis that we made are slightly large, but don't worry about it, we will flip it halfway. Just be careful guys, don't use a metal tong while it is cooking because you can get a shock. So whenever you want to move the roti or touch it, stop the toaster then touch it. You can see how beautifully the rotis are puffing. Looks amazing, isn't it? Halfway done, we will stop the toaster, pull the rotis up, carefully flip the rotis and then cook them until they are golden from the other side as well. Hardly takes a minute guys, here you can see our rotis are done. Such a nice color and these are super crispy. Karari baniye na tandoori roti. Tried and tested recipe guys, as always. Here I'm cooking the second batch. You can see how well the rotis are puffing. Now it's time to serve with the piping hot butter dal. And for garnishing, I'm adding the rogan that we saved earlier. Final touch, some coriander leaves. So how was the video guys? If you enjoyed it, click the like button and share it with your friends. If you did not like it, click the dislike button. Which other kind of recipe would you like to see? Do comment down below. Bye, take care.